today's video, we're going to be talking about relative maximum and minimum values. So what is a relative maximum or a relative minimum value? It's the point at which a function changes from being increasing to decreasing, or if it's going to be consistent. Right? So it's those points where that change is happening. These are our relative maximums and our relative minimum values. So ultimately, it's a point where the graph changes from increasing to decreasing, or from where it goes from decreasing to increasing. So we're going to go ahead and do a couple examples where we're going to use a graphing utility to approximate the relative minimum or the maximum, depending on what they have, right, for our following functions, because they could have one or both. So let's go ahead and pull up our calculator here, and let's graph our first function. So here we have our y equals negative 4x squared minus 7x plus 3, and we're going to go ahead and hit graph. And here we can see that we have a maximum value. So to find that maximum value, we're going to calculate the maximum. So above the word trace, we have the word calc. So we're going to hit second trace, which will give us our calculations menu. And we're going to go to maximum value. Hit enter. Now it asks us here for our left bound. So right now, you can see my flashing cursor is on the right side of our little maximum. So we need to go to the left side. So now I'm on the left side, so I'm going to hit enter. And then it's going to say, okay, please go to the right bound. Well, it just says right bound question mark, but that's what that means. So we're going to go over here to our right side of the maximum, hit enter, and it's like, okay, do you want me to guess this? Because remember, when we're using a calculator, it's estimating for us when it comes to graphing and doing these things. So we're going to hit enter, and it's going to tell us that we have a maximum value at negative 0.88 and with a y at 6.06. So let's go ahead and let's write that down. And we don't have a minimum because this is a quadratic function. We know that we just have just the one bump. So let's go ahead and let's plug in our second one. So here we go, y equals, we'll clear out what we've got. We have let's try that again. 2x raised to the third power plus 3x squared minus 12x. And let's go ahead and graph that. This is a cube, so we're going to end up with a couple different bumps here. And as you can see, one of them is kind of off the screen. So if we zoom out, we'll see it. It's kind of extreme right there. So let's go ahead and let's modify our window a little bit. So let's go from maybe negative 10 to positive 10. And then for our y's, let's go from maybe negative 30 to 30, and let's see what that looks like. Oh, much better. So we're going to calculate the maximum here and the minimum. So we're going to go to second, calc. We'll do our maximum first. And again, we're going to move our cursor to the left bound side. So we're there. So we'll enter. Then we're going to move it to the right bound. Now we're only moving it to the right bound of the maximum. Notice where it made my line. Then I'm going to have it guess. And well, that's nice. It says it's at negative 2 comma 20. So let's write that down. And now we're ready to calculate our minimum. So second, calculate, we'll go to minimum. And it says go to the left bound. We're going to the left bound of our minimum. So we're going to come down here. We're on the left side of our minimum value right here. Hit enter. And then we have to go to the right side of that minimum value and hit enter. And notice that our minimum is between those two lines that have been created. That's how we know we've done it right. So I hit enter, and it says negative, or it's got 1.000, so we'll say 1, comma negative 7. So let's write that down. And so we have just found our relative maximum and minimum values using our graphing utility.